Well, we know that Nashville is a very international city, but did you know you can come see a Latin American garden right smack in the middle of town? Well, I'm at Vanderbilt University, where we have a Latin American Studies Ethnobotanical Garden. All right, for those of us that are traveling around and we want to get to know a little bit more about countries before we go, plants is a great way. So what kind of countries do you have represented here?
So we represent really from the southeastern United States all the way down to Paraguay, Uruguay, and Brazil. And so one of the plants that I can tell you about today is, this is from Brazil. This is a cassava tree. And cassava is one of the most important root crops in the world. In the tropics, it's the third most important food staple after rice and corn. So incredibly important. And so the roots of this tree are eaten. This species actually is able to survive here in Nashville in a temperate climate. And so it's not the species that people generally eat of cassava. This species is really inedible, but it's very similar to it. And so you would find this in Brazil.
Well, this is very familiar to me because it's a beautiful milkweed plant. And what country is it from?
This milkweed plant is native to Mexico. As you can see, it also grows very well here. And so, yeah, people grow these as ornamentals. They grow them to support the monarch migration. We also have a number of other ornamental plants here in the garden. This species of beauty berry is native to Mexico, grows all the way down to Bolivia, but it's very similar to the one that we have in the southeast that people grow in their gardens.
So this has the most beautiful leaves. Tell me all about it.
So this is known, this plant is native to Mexico and Central America, and it's called Yerba Santo, Santa in those regions. And it contains safrol, which you may know is the active ingredient in the sassafras root that was traditionally used to make root beer. We now know that safrol is a carcinogen, but it does supply this very peppery, spicy, anise-like taste that's very delicious.
Well, so I notice a bit of beautiful purple flowering too.
Yes, this is the Mexican petunia, and I see this. It grows along the roadside in Mexico and the Yucatan, but it also grows here. People use it as an ornamental in their gardens because it grows very well. This is a sterile form. It can become invasive, so that's something to be careful with.
Oh, always a good idea. Now, also, it looks like you've got hibiscus.
Yes, this is the sleeping hibiscus, and it has medicinal purposes as well, but it has beautiful red flowers, and you will find these in gardens throughout the southeast of the United States.
Well, once again, Avery, I'm finding a plant that I grow at my house, these beautiful 4 o'clocks.
Yes. 4 o'clocks are native to Peru. So this is one of the plants that we have in the garden that shows the diversity of our Latin American program. And we have a lot of depth in Peru at Vanderbilt. And so the 4 o'clocks are native to Peru, which I think many of us don't know.
Had no idea. And right next to it, I'm seeing leaves from the passion vine.
Yes, this is the passion flower, belongs to the genus Passiflora, our state wildflower. This is a different species, so this is known as the blue passion flower. Unfortunately, its fruits are not as tasty as the maypop fruits, which are produced by the passion flower that's native to the southeast. But there is a species that grows in South America. This one is also native to South America, that's used in fruit smoothies called maracuya. That's very delicious.
Yum, sounds great. Well, and now we're entering a beautiful sage world.
Yes, so this is our sage section. We have a number of different plants. This is the hot lip sage that's native to Mexico and grows really well as an ornamental here in the southeast. This is hummingbird sage, which you might be familiar with.
I see hummingbirds at it at my yard all the time.
And that's wonderful. So this plant is native to Paraguay and Uruguay, so southern South America. This is the blue anise sage, which is native to Mexico and is also grown as an ornamental in the southeast as well as in the southwestern part of the United States.
Very neat. Another favorite of mine, pineapple sage.
Pineapple sage, yes, the leaves smell delicious. It has beautiful red flowers. Unfortunately, this one is not in bloom right now. This plant is native to the highlands of Guatemala and Mexico. And finally, we have the Mexican bush sage. So this grows wild in the deserts of northern Mexico and has a number of uses as well.
Well, I'm feeling very, very Latin American with my garden now. Okay, well, this wins for the scariest, most amazing plant I've seen.
Yeah, so this is one of my favorite plants, precisely that. It looks like some sort of prehistoric thing. It's got spikes on the top and on the bottom of the leaves, as you can see here, and all throughout its stem. So this plant is the lulo or naranjilla, and it is native to Colombia and Ecuador. In fact, the species, its scientific name is Solanum quitoense, and so that tells you that it's native to the Quito region of Ecuador and that general region of South America. So the fruits, as you can see right here, hard little citrusy fruits that when they're mature will be orange colored, and they're very delicious. They're used in jams and jellies to make liquid beverages and so on.
These are one of my favorite things to see, and you don't really see them enough. They're so beautiful.
They are so beautiful, and they grow so well here in Tennessee. So this, of course, is amaranth. It's an incredibly nutritious plant. It's a pseudo cereal, and so you can eat the grains. It's very similar in many ways to quinoa. It's got a very high protein content. The leaves also are very healthy for you. And this plant was very important in the Aztec culture. So it was collected from the different states throughout the Aztec Empire, along with beans, corn, and chia as a tribute item.
Well, one of the things I love to eat is cactus.
Yeah, cactus is delicious. So this is our thornless prickly pear. The pads can be eaten. Generally, they're cut into strips, and they might be marinated or they might be cooked. They're very delicious and very good for you. The fruit of the prickly pear cactus can also be eaten.
Well, so is this wonderful plant easy to grow?
Yes, this one is pretty easy to grow here. It's native to northern Mexico, and so does very well in the southeast of the United States.
All of these plants look so wonderful, and clearly they're things that grow well in our climate. So for all of us that want to know more about Latin American plants, how can we use you as a resource?
We believe that the garden is actually the perfect example of how Latin America can be taught across different disciplines, different subjects of school. And so we do professional development workshops for local educators, and we actually have people come from around the country. So if you're interested, please reach out to us on our website, the Center for Latin American Studies at Vanderbilt University, and we would be happy to set up a tour for you or let you come. We welcome people to come to the garden anytime and have an interactive experience with the plants.
Well, this has been great, and this is so inspiring. And you know, I think we all can come out and travel the world a little bit just by walking through a garden. So next time you're near Vanderbilt, stop by, see what you like.
For inspiring garden tours, growing tips, and garden projects, visit our website at volunteergardener.org or on YouTube at the Volunteer Gardener channel, and like us on Facebook.